What's up, villagers? This is KJ4A, and welcome back to my Realm of Rulers Let's Play. Last video, we got off to a good start with building our little town right here, but then at the end, we weren't paying attention to food, and someone starved to death, so we got to rectify that. Today, we'll be working on food and housing for our new settlements. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give that like button a little of the old clickety-click, and if you're new here, please remember to subscribe for more daily videos. All right, so if you need to get food quickly, I mentioned this last video, you're looking for those little red bushes that I'm kind of, like, suspect. Are we sure we ran out of food and someone didn't just get poisoned with, like, poison berries or something? I don't know, but this seems to be the only place we can get food, so let's go ahead and get some red berries for these guys. And then after that, we are going to work on, I think it's a cook or a kitchen or something like that. And then we're going to build some housing so we can start expanding our empire of starvation or whatever. Anyway, so there we go. We did put down the well, so we got the water situation done. And I was just going on about how I like the developers, and I kind of like, you know, I'm gonna look into them and try and get to know them, and hopefully this game is gonna go somewhere. And then our miners freaking starved to death. Oh boy. Well, we do have enough to train another miner, so we're gonna go ahead and do that right now. Our wonderful lovely, does she have a name? I don't know. Our lovely, lovely... Man, she looks evil, doesn't she? Look at her eyes, man. What's wrong with you? You sure you're not a witch? Anyway, she's our farmer, and she's been doing a great job. She's not farming food or anything, but she's, I don't think she's really meant to. I think she's supposed to be farming this barley stuff. All right. So let's see what we need for our next item, which is going to be the cooking station. 200 logs and 100 stone. My goodness. All right. Well, let's start getting some logs, people. So, are you guys excited? I'm doing these videos back to back. I'm hoping you guys were excited about last video, because I've been watching Game Edge play this game. And actually, before him, I was watching what's his name? Damn it! I'm sorry, I can't remember his name. I watch a lot of his stuff with his early access games. It's kind of like Keem, but not Keem. Maybe Beam, Meme. Damn it! I'm sorry, guys. Someone let me know in the comments who the guy is that was doing these videos. I'm really just pissed off that I can't remember the guy's name. Anyway, yeah, so I've been watching him do it for a while, and then I watched Game Edge play, and I was like, you know what, that's going to be my next game. Other games kept coming up here and there, so, you know, I couldn't do this game as early as I wanted to, but, you know, we're going to stop what we're doing right now and go get some food just to make sure nobody's going to starve. Yeah, so I wanted to get to it, but other games kept coming up, and I finally got a chance to play it, and I mentioned last video, man, this game was started, like, I can't believe it. It's been in development since the 1st of December, and this is what they've got so far. I think that's really good. So I'm really excited, and I hope the developers are super serious and going to see this thing through, because I think this could be something special. You know, we play games like RimWorld, and I'm trying to think of other city builders. Stonehearth is another city builder, and there was another one, Towns, although Towns has just been abandoned, which was a damn shame. But anyway, there was another one, Stone something. I don't remember. I played them all, but they're all top down, and this is first person. This could be really something amazing, you know? Very excited. Very excited. Okay, so let's take a look. We've got the resources we need for the cooking station, and we're going to put that right here. Remember when you're placing something, see how it's like crooked? You don't want it going down crooked. You want to look for flat area. That is pretty flat right there. I think that's a good spot for the cooking station, and boom. He looks like he's a little bit in the ground, but, you know, what are you going to do? Early access. But he's working. You can't do anything with him. He's automatic. Think of him like a food version of the well, which is basically what he is. And now we are using 4 water per 30 seconds, 4 food per 30 seconds, and we are getting 5 food being gathered, I'm guessing, per 30 seconds. So we now have automatic food. We are self-sustained, and I could just, like, go in the other room and watch an episode of Malcolm in the Middle and come back, and these guys will be gathering stuff. I don't have to worry about food or water myself, so you could just leave. I don't know if anything attacks. I don't think there's any animals out there, although I think there is bandits now, which are something new, but I really don't know how they work or even if they are in the game. So next thing we're going to look at, we need to look at expanding. So what we're going to look for now is we're going to make a house. So we're going to need 600 logs and 200 stone. My goodness. You might say, well, Cage, just save up for the tavern. Well, you know, maybe, but I kind of want the house. Because the thing is, okay, here's why making the house makes sense. Okay, and I'll tell you why. Right now, I only have 4 people gathering. If I wait for a tavern or even a large house, I'm going to have 4 people gathering all of the materials I need for these big cost items. Okay. But if I put down a regular house, yeah, I wasted, well, not really wasted. Because if you use 600 logs, let's just look at the logs alone. Actually, the stone you're kind of wasting too. If you put down 600 logs and 200 stone for four people, and then you put down a large house for eight people, you just wasted 200 wood and 200 stone and saved yourself five iron bars, because you'd have to make two houses to make up for one large house. And it takes 1,200 oak logs and 1,000 oak logs. So that's 200 oak logs wasted. That's 200 stones wasted. And that's, you saved five iron bars. But here's the thing. Instead of having four people helping you gather for these two items, you have eight. So to gather for the large house and to gather for the tavern will go quicker because you'll have more people. So I'm fully on board with the house. I know you're wasting resources, but in the long run, I think it's definitely the way to go. So the stone, oh boy, we have nothing. Okay, well, everyone seems to be doing their job. I really can't complain, but we are going to have to gather some resources here ourselves as well. So let me get to work. All right, I just went ahead and got like 925 wood, 242 stones, slept through the night, and let's check our town and see what's going on with it. So food is going up, but it's going up slowly, but it doesn't matter as long as it's going up. I mean, if this is going the way I think it's going, I should be getting one food every 30 seconds, but I'm not really sure if that's the case. All right, so where do we want to put a living quarters? I think we might want to put our living quarters over here. I don't really think we have to put our living quarters close. Oh, I don't like that. I don't really think we have to put our living quarters close. I'd like to leave this open. So, although I don't really like this dip here, but this doesn't look very flat either. Well, let's see what the house looks like. All right. So that's the house. Again, we want it as flat as possible. See, that's, if you put it like this, it's going to look like crap. I can almost guarantee you. So what we do is we're going to put it over here. Yeah. Okay. So we want it as close as possible, but as far enough that's needed to not be in the way. I think that's a great spot for it. There's the house. All right. I don't know what that is. Like a little porch or something. I think this is the door. Can we not? I could have swore you could go in the houses. Maybe not. I don't know. Could have swore you could have. Nah, maybe you can't. Okay. So whatever. The house is going to give us the ability to hire more. Train. I guess train is the word they use. To train more they're citizens. That's what they are. They're citizens. All right, so we can now have eight. But if we get one more, wait, why did our food go down that much? Okay, now it just went up. Okay, so we're getting five every 30 seconds. It's going down four every 30 seconds. That's what happened. Okay, so if we get one more guy, we're nothing's going to change with our food and water. So what do I want? Honestly, I think I want another lumberjack. I know the guy getting stone, the miner, is really, really slow. But a farmer wouldn't be bad either to get more barley. No, tough call. We'll go with the farmer. I'd like to get more barley. If we get the barley quicker, then we'll have barley to get more people, to train more people later. So now everything should be equal, five and five all the way down the board. This should not be changing at all. It might go down by five and up by five, depending on the tick of the 30 seconds. But now we're going to be looking at another well and another cook. So what do we need for those again? I don't remember. It was so long ago. All right, the water well. Oh, boy, we don't have enough stone. And the cooking station. We need more stone. Okay, maybe we should have went with a miner. I think our next guy's probably going to be a miner. Although, I don't know. Wood still seems really coming in really slow. All right, this is a little weird. How do I get rid of this? How do I bring it up? V? Okay, V to get rid of it. V is such a weird key to bring up a crafting menu, so that's why I was a little confused by that. All right, let's go ahead and get some stone here. Okay, yeah, so I was watching something on my second monitor. I got a little bit more stone than I meant to. Sue me. All right, what the hell was I going to build? Oh, that's right. We need food and water. Okay, so another water well. Put that right next to the other one. There's no reason not to. Put it behind it. Yeah, that looks pretty good. It's not too close, right? Nope. There we go. Oh, that looks good. Right in the shade. Keeping your water in the shade. I mean, come on, guys. Like, these guys are going to love me. Look at this. Look at all these guys. Oh, look at the barley. Oh, two crazy witch women. Oh, my God. You are a psycho. Look at you. And no, I'm not going to make any comments about her ample body stuff. I had to address it, or people would have been like, come on, Cage, really? Come on. All right, cooking station. All right, so put this one right next to the other one. I'm going to rotate this. Let's try and bring it closer to us so we don't have to put it so far away. Is that that's the closest he'll get to me, huh? That's not very close. All right, well, let's put this guy right next to his buddy. They could talk about, you know, I don't know, recipes and stuff. Who knows? Whatever people like to talk about. Whatever cooks like to talk about. All right, that looks pretty decent. All right, wow. That worked out really well. Okay, so we should be at 10 food and water per 30 seconds now. What? Yeah, 10. All right, we could hire another five people now. Okay, so what do we want? We definitely want a miner and a lumberjack. And I think we'll leave that last spot open just in case, you know, we'll see what else we need. It's probably going to be a lumberjack or a miner, I guess. I don't think we need another farmer. All right, well, do we have enough for another house? No, we need more wood. Oh, yeah. Let's make another lumberjack. Screw it. I think that's the way to go. Okay. So we now have four lumberjacks, two miners, and two of the farmers. So can we sleep yet? It looks a little... Nope. Gotta wait for night. It's okay. How you guys doing? What are you making in here, huh? What do you got? What do you got? Some flour, some rice. What do you got going on here? So this looks like it's got wood holding up the bowl. That wood would catch on fire, wouldn't it? It looks like wood. Maybe it's not wood. Maybe it's something else. All right. Well, we're gonna need trees. So let's go ahead and get some more wood while we wait for nighttime. And I guess the next thing is to make another house. I'm probably gonna make one more house, and then I think at that point I will start saving up for the next big building. Let me see what else I can make besides buildings. All right. Yeah, that's good. Okay, advanced buildings, storage, we got that. Blacksmith. I don't know what the blacksmith is for. Maybe he turns... Oh, you know what? I'll bet you he cooks everything for me. Like, he probably cooks the clay and the ingots for me, so I don't have to do it myself. Wooden gate, standing torch. Ooh, a standing torch. Nah, I don't really want to waste my stuff on that just yet. So food and water storage. I don't really see the need for food and water storage, like, at all. So, because these things getting us food and water are guaranteed. Like, it's not like, like nobody's even, like, harvesting the food or bringing up the water. It's being worked automatically. So as long as we keep this number higher than this number, the storage means nothing. So... I'll make it eventually, but it's not really high on my part. Oh boy, look at that. So that's a bug. It looks like the sun's showing through the ground or something. All right, let's go ahead and pass the night. Oh, still daytime. Is it nighttime now? Okay. So I guess that big light sun shining through the bottom of the ground thing is to signify the changeover tonight. You know what? I think I will make a blacksmith. Oh, we're going to need 20 bricks for that. Okay. All right. Well, that's fine because we got the forge right here. So this is the snowballs are the clay, right? Yeah. The snowballs are the clay and the clay is the stone. It's freaking crazy. This game's crazy. And the cantaloupes are the iron. Or coconuts. But I usually call coconuts cantaloupes anyway for some reason. I don't know why. It's like a thing with me. All right, you know what, guys? I'm going to have a change of plans here. We're not going to make the blacksmith this video. You know, this is taking a long time, and the settlers aren't really doing that much because I don't have enough of them. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to make something new, but I think we're going to make a large house. And we've got what we need for it. There's no reason not to. Oh, wow, that is large. They weren't joking. All right, so let's see where the front is. Where's the front? Is that the front? Oh, yeah, that's the front. Okay. So we get this as flat as possible. It looks pretty flat to me. Is it too close to the other house? That looks pretty good. Okay. And the shadows are pretty crazy in this game. Can we go in here? No. I know the last of the tavern we can go in. It's kind of a shame you can't go in these. But yeah, so there we go. We got another one of those down. So now we're going to get some more guys, man. Definitely got to get some more lumberjacks. No joke. We can get another two guys, so let's get two lumberjacks. There we go. Did I get the second one? I clicked the second one. It didn't go through. Maybe you got to wait a little bit. Hey, I'm 104 of 100. I wasn't supposed to be able to go over 100. Right, let's get another one. There we go. Now we're all nice and equal. Everything should be going good. And we've got six lumberjacks. Now the wood better start coming in, man. Like, start doing your job, you damn lumberjacks. It looks like two farmers good. Probably could have got away with one farmer. I just would have had to do this a little bit more. Two farmers does seem good. Again, I seem to get stone quicker than wood. I'm not really sure if that's the case, but that's what it feels like. So I think having a lot of lumberjacks is definitely the way to go. All right, we need to get some more water and such up. So let's go ahead and see what we need for that. So we're going to need a 300 wood. And we've got enough stone, so let's just get more wood. Yeah, see what I'm saying? It's always about wood in this game. You're going to get one or five. I don't know. I seem to get... I don't know. Maybe I do get more... I probably... You know what the thing is? I get more wood, but you also need like 10 times more wood. Where you need like, you know, a couple hundred stone, maybe 300 stone. You need like 1,000 wood or something. So I think the idea is that I'm getting more wood, but it also... You just use so freaking much. So now what we'll do is we will put down another... We could probably do it this video. Yeah, we could do it this video. So what we'll do is we'll put down another well, and then we'll make another cooking station, and that will allow us to make another five people, train another five people. The barley's going to actually hold us back at this point, which is fine. I'm okay with that. I'm probably just going to go with a couple lumberjacks, to be honest. Well, maybe three lumberjacks, one miner, and one farmer. Well, see, I don't even know if I want another farmer. I don't think I really need one. How much wood did I say? I did say 300, right? Yeah, 300. Okay. Water well. And we'll put that right here. Looking good. Looking good. Put another cooking guy right here. I don't know where to put him. Yeah, we could put one more right here. I might have to put a fourth... When I put my fourth guy down, I might have to have another... A different cooking area. All right. Looks pretty good. Yep. I like it. I like it a lot. That should allow me to have 15 people. And my housing should allow me to have 16. So, let's go with... Do we want to go with a farmer? I don't know. Definitely three lumberjacks. Two. Three... A miner. Nope. See, we can't even do a miner. I don't know. I'm not really sure. Getting barley just seems a lot easier than going out there and getting wood or stone. Although it's technically just as fast to get stone as barley. I'm just debating if I want another farmer. Oh, by the way, check it out. 50 barley. I forgot about that. They're not harvesting that, so I guess I have to harvest that. That's okay, though. All right. I don't think I want another farmer. I think I want... Maybe two more miners. I don't have enough for two more miners. But we definitely want one more miner. And I think we should probably go with a fourth miner. I don't know what the lumberjacks to miner... Yeah, we definitely don't need as many farmers as miners. So we either get another lumberjack or another miner. I think I'm going to go another lumberjack because I can afford that quicker. And I just, you know, I just hate chopping. I don't know, something about chopping trees in this game. I'm not digging it. Okay, so another lumberjack. There we go. And we're at 15 of everything. And our citizens are just about maxed. I think next video, we will have to make another something. You know what? Next video, why don't we make next video the tavern? I think I could probably do that. Probably. And, or maybe, I'm not sure. I might do another large house. I'm not really sure. It's either tavern or large house. And after that, we will put down another water well, another cooking station, and just start bringing more people in and continue growing. It's looking good. It's looking really, really good. All right, guys. We are going to call this one here. So that's going to be it for this episode. I will see you next time. Till then, take it easy.